how to change the oil on a 2001 Ford Mustang. You can use what you learn here to change your oil on your old car. The first thing you need to do is know what type of oil your car uses. Here's mine. It's 5W20. Then gotta locate the oil filter. Mine is right there. And this is typical on most Fords. They have it on the front, but on Hondas and Toyotas, they usually have it behind the engine. So it's usually way over there, behind and to the bottom. There's a few basic equipment that we're gonna need and supplies, such as some motor oil with the same rating. We're also gonna need a funnel to pour the new oil in. We're also gonna need the an oil drain pan to collect the old oil. And we're gonna also need a special tool to remove the oil filter. And there are several different types and sizes, like this one. For my car, it uses the number 2 oil filter wrench. And then this is for a Honda, uses a smaller one. And this is for a bigger car that uses a bigger oil filter wrench. This is a number 1. And then we have a universal one. Here it is. And these are to remove the oil filter, because to put it on, you don't need that much torque. And we're also going to use a new oil filter. I happen to have this one on hand, but I usually use other brands. This is the cheapest one. And let me know in the comments below which ones do you guys usually use, because everyone has their own brand that they like. But those are the basic tools. Now let's get to it. Now we're going to use the oil drain plug plus the wrench. This one is a size 13, and most of my tools are metric because my first car was a Honda and they used the metric. But we're going to place this underneath over there. That's where the oil drain bolt is. So let's get in there. And there's the old oil filter. But we're gonna remove that last. First is the oil drain plug bolt, which is right there. And I have already placed the pan right underneath, and we're gonna loosen it up. I managed to get the bolt loose with the wrench, which is very long because sometimes it's very tight. And I forgot to mention that I always wear gloves because the oil is going to drain. Also, a lot of people like to change the oil when it's hot because it flows easier, but I don't, because the oil is going to be very hot and you could get burned. So almost there. and it's gonna start dripping. See, that's why I like to wear gloves. Both all full of oil. See, I got my hands full of oil, and that's gonna drain for about 5 minutes. And I'm also gonna open the cap at the top to let it breathe and flow easily. Okay, while the oil is draining at the bottom, I'm gonna be removing this one, this cap right here, so I can get some air and it will drain faster. But we gotta be careful that no dust or leaves fall on it. So I'm just gonna leave it like that. Now that the oil is draining, I'm gonna be removing the oil filter. And I'm gonna do it with the bottom. And we're also gonna prep the new one, which has this seal right here. This rubber seal, we gotta be careful when we remove the new one that it doesn't stay on the car, that it comes out with the old one and then in with the new one. Oops. To prep this new one, I'm gonna be adding some oil to it, brand new oil, and we're just gonna need just a little bit. There you go. And this oil is gonna spread it around the seal. Around the threads. And this is gonna allow it to seal and it gets installed. So there you go. And to remove this oil filter, I already got it loose with the tool. You can see. And we're gonna move the oil pan directly underneath. So oil gets captured. There you go. And this is why I wear gloves, because there you go. Kind of fell on me. Oh well. I'll clean it up. For the new one, it's not going in. Wonder why. And these are not supposed to be really tight, so just hand tighten. There you go. The new oil filter is installed. Now we gotta put the plug back on, but some oil is still draining, and we're gonna wait till it stops. Okay, the oils, it stopped draining. Now it's just dripping, but I don't want to wait any longer. So I'll be putting the bolt back on. And when you put this back on, make sure you don't over tighten. Because just remember, you're going to be taking this off again. If it's too tight, you can damage the threading. So just be careful. It's kind of hard to film and do this at the same time. I'm sorry about the bad angle, but I'm doing this with one hand, another hand in the camera, so there you go. Now to get this tight. There you go. Now we can give it a little bit. There you go. Doesn't need any more. And that. Now we just gotta move everything. Be very careful not to spill the oil like I did earlier, because I was using one hand. And then we're gonna fill it up with new oil. And I always use a funnel. There you go. Got the new oil ready. And then we're gonna fill it up. And usually you should know the capacity in your car. Mine is exactly 5 quarts. And I don't wanna spill any oil around. So we can use this, and I want to go get a t-shirt, put it right here in case I spill any oil. Okay, usually I keep an old t-shirt as a rag. Couldn't find it, but got this towel. This should be enough. Hopefully I don't spill too much. It's kind of difficult to do this with one hand, but there you go. I'm not gonna need to use two hands for this. So I finished pouring the oil. I'm just gonna put the cap back on. And the car is basically done. But I always like to take this moment to check the brake fluid that it has on the there. So far it looks right there. Looks like it's good. I also like to check the coolant reservoir, which is our expansion tank, which is right here. Right here is the maximum line, which right now has a good quantity, good level. But if it's low, you gotta add a little bit more and make sure it's not leaking any color. There you go. And make sure to change your oil every 3,000 to 5,000 miles, because the old oil, take it to your local auto parts. They should recycle your oil. Right, thanks for watching. Let me know in the comments below if you guys change your own oil or take it to the service department to get our oil changed. But I'd like to change my own oil. Alright guys, thanks for watching and till next time.